No shortage of things to discuss with infectious disease doctor Zane Chagla, because, well, so much has changed since the last time you were even on with the steady growth of the Omicron variant. Good to see you, Zane. Okay, let's start with yesterday. There's lots of announcements. Let's break some of those down. What were your thoughts on them?
Yeah, so, I mean, we had a reduction of large venues, which I think obviously is reasonable considering how fast things spread. The testing guidance, I think, was something that we did need. You know, I know a lot of people need testing. A lot of people are in line for testing as cases and contacts. But we have to really think fundamentally about what testing will do. And testing here is the ability for people who work in critical settings dealing with vulnerable patients to diagnose themselves with COVID to prevent outbreaks. It's people who are at high risk of complications where we have therapeutics like monoclonal antibodies to intervene to keep them out of hospital. And unfortunately, for the rest of folks, you know, we just don't have the capacity to test every person with a runny nose. And I think that there was some need to be very pragmatic about what that means and allowing people to isolate for a short amount of time to reduce their risk.
Was the fear of numbers? I've talked to you about this in the past. We see those numbers every day and they continue to climb and we continue to set records. Did that have anything to do with it, making that decision to only PCR test high-risk individuals?
Yeah, I mean, look, what's happened in South Africa, what we're seeing in the United Kingdom, what we're seeing in Denmark, you know, the numbers are extraordinary, right? You know, the numbers that we're reporting day-to-day are not accurate. They're probably 5 to 10 times higher in terms of the actual case numbers, right? And so, again, if you have all of these people that are positive in the community, we're talking about hundreds of thousands of people now with an active case. You know, you do have to say, okay, what is the point of this? It's to prevent people from getting to hospital. It's to prevent outbreaks in hospitals and long-term care. And if all of the testing is coming through that line, you have to make sure that those priorities are dealt with first. And right now, you know, testing right now in the province can really only accommodate that chunk of individuals.
There was some good news, though. 54% the Omicron virus less deadly than Delta. So that has to be good.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. It doesn't mean that we're not going to have a stressful couple of weeks. And you know, someone put an elegant quote out there. If it's a quarter less deadly, but four times as many people get it, you kind of lose your advantage there. But we are seeing lots of scientific studies, lab studies, really suggesting the infection of the lung cells, what causes pneumonia, what causes people to get sick and end up in the ICU, is much more blunted with Omicron than it is with prior variants like Delta. And so hopefully even those hospitalizing, I think what we're seeing is a lot of people are hospitalized with COVID, but not necessarily from COVID. And their prognosis is actually quite good. The length of stay in hospital is only a few days as compared to weeks in the past. And so, you know, we're going to feel some pressure. But I don't think this is going to be what we dealt with prior waves. And again, we're so much more protected with vaccinations in our population.
Because you're seeing those hospitals is still a topic. It's our top story today because you just don't have the bodies working in the hospitals because they're off sick. So that's why that PCR testing to those most high-risk individuals.
Exactly. We have to get people back to work, right? You know, people who have COVID symptoms, symptoms that are, you know, attributable to COVID, exposures to COVID, you know, who unfortunately are dealing with an outbreak, we need them tested quickly and we need them back to work quickly. This is going to affect a lot of facets of society, not just healthcare, but again, you know, being able to make sure that healthcare can function through this wave, deal with patients, be able to kind of work through it. And at least, you know, from the data from South Africa, this is going to be a short up and a short down. But to be able to get through that period is going to be critical for us to have healthcare workers around and deal with the complications. And so, again, you know, this is where testing is so importantly dedicated to those sectors.
And it's just self-identifying. That's from that 10 to 5 days for everybody that feels, I don't know if you feel sick, self-isolate for 5 days rather than that 10.
Yeah, and it's pragmatic, right? It's not perfect. There may be some people infectious at the end of day six. There may be some people that isolate that don't have COVID. But if you try to split the difference, you try to make it tolerable for people. We know even with COVID, most of the transmission happens before you're symptomatic to a couple of days afterwards. I think, again, this bridges the gap to say using that as a control measure, not making people lose income or their jobs for 5 days off versus 10 days off, you know, it makes it more tolerable, it makes it more acceptable. And again, you know, it bridges the gap for our unfortunate lack of testing for low-risk populations.
I have six more questions and we have no more time. So that's normally how things work when I talk to you. Listen, we appreciate you being on each and every Friday throughout this year. Hopefully we can continue in 2022. I want you to enjoy your New Year's, have a drink, charge it to producer Don, okay? Just put it on his bill. Enjoy your night. I appreciate that you're all doing for us. Dr. Zane Chagla, who's been joining us each and every Friday here on Morning Live.
Thanks. Take care.